So we're at Fort Peck's quarantine facility that they built for their buffalo. We're also in the middle of thousands of acres of their buffalo pastures. And you know, we're surrounded by the buffalo that live here wild and free at Fort Peck.
Building those numbers back up, and we're able to move these animals, you know, to different tribal lands that there aren't any buffalo left. And so having that cultural connection, that spiritual connection, that brings us a sense of hope. I think it also shows that, you know, we're still here as Native people, and you know, we still have a story to tell.
Yeah. I mean, it's really important to kind of celebrate what just happened today, but also I think it's really important to reflect on the history here, because a lot of people don't know, but tribes introduced the first proposal to quarantine Yellowstone buffalo as an alternative to slaughter about 30 years ago. And that was one of the earliest actions that the Intertribal Buffalo Council, back then was Intertribal Bison Cooperative, got together and made a resolution to become a part of this issue here.
Our goal of ITBC has always been to return buffalo back to our lands for our spiritual and our cultural connection to the buffalo.
Having the Yellowstone bison here is important to us as a tribe for a couple reasons. One, it expands their footprint as it needs to be done, since they have been more or less decimated over the last 100+ years. It's also good for us because it helps diversify the genes of our herd.
And to me, it's become a passion to get these animals out and work with them and get them to tribes, and you know, along with my tribe too. And there's so many things like with our people that we've lost, and buffalo was one of them, a real big main part of our lives. And so to be able to do that, to get these animals back to tribes, to me is a real big success, and to get that big part of our culture back.